Hi guys, how you doing? Welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is Taiwo. I'm an immigrant here in Canada. So now let's talk about why you should not depend on minimum wage job in Canada, especially for dependent. So this video targets the dependent people on open work permit. You know, maybe you know, husband, wife, couples. Your partner is schooling here in Canada and you are here on open work permit. Do not depend on minimum wage job. Coming from Africa, we all think, oh man, I'll be working maybe $15 per hour, blah, 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 and also take care of the family. But see, the when you arrive here, you understand that those $15 per hour, $16 per hour job cannot take you anywhere. And especially for a dependent, so now you need to feed the family from from the minimum wage job. You also need to save. You have to save, you know, for your partner's school fee, studying, and every other thing. So you'll be the one to cater. Especially even if you are here with your children, you also have to, like, you pay for the daycare, you know, for the school fee and some other things, so on, all that miscellaneous. So now minimum wage job will take you nowhere in Canada here, because half of this money goes to tax. So now if you're earning minimum wage job, maybe bi-weekly you're earning like maybe your take home will be less than $1,000 or maybe 1,100. So now, and 1,100 bi-weekly will take you nowhere, because you have to pay for your apartment. And a normal maybe two bedroom flat for family, for couple, two bedroom apartment is around 1,200, 1,300, 1,400, 1,600, depending on your province. Even if you are going for the basement, at least basements you pay like $1,000. So now for basement, 1,002, depending. If you are in the GTA in the town, you'll be paying more. So now for amenities and some other things. So now bi-weekly you are taking home $1,000 home after tax. So there will be nothing left, you know, after paying for the house rent and some other stuff. So now you think, okay, maybe, you know, back home we all think, oh, that, you know, those money is much. But the reality is that when you get here, those money, the 15 minimum wage job is nothing. You can start with a minimum wage job when you arrive. I do advise people, as soon as you arrive, start looking for a job. Anyhow, even if it's minimum wage job, you can start, but do not depend. You know, that's just, don't get confused, but do not stay long on minimum wage job. While working as a minimum wage, at maybe at that restaurant, at that factory or anything, just keep looking, improving yourself, get a class 5. I do tell people, like, as soon as you learn, go for your knowledge test, get a class 5. It will increase your chances of getting a better job, even as a driver. Company driver, we are in the province that I am right now, they will pay nothing less than $20-something per hour just for you to have that class 5. So now, and even delivery drivers, like company delivery drivers, I've seen a delivery job of $30, $32, you know, per hour. Those with $32, you will save, you will pay for anything, you will live convenient. So far, you didn't go beyond your distance. So now, and also, most of this job, also work on yourself. Even if you're a man, go for, what's it called, for any all this training, forklift training, one lift training, all this training. Forklift training is just 2 days, so it will take you just 2 days to get certified on as a forklift. So when you get employed, the company will orientate you and they will teach you more. So now just go for forklift training, what's it called, or any training that you think is okay. You know, just look for your environment, check if they are coming there, they are looking for forklift training, you know, they are looking for more lift training, they are looking for a technician. And so now all these basic things they will teach you during the orientation. So do not depend on minimum wage job. You can start with a minimum wage job, but don't stay long. As I'm not talking to the student, I focus this video on the dependent. Don't stay long as a minimum, you know, do, working as a minimum wage. Okay. So in Canada, you can just do it for like a month maximum or 2 months, then switch immediately. Because so now the third, the thing is that you can also do driving. As soon as you get your class 5, look for a normal 2,000, 3,000 vehicle. You can, you know, also start driving, you know, as a part-time, or you know, after your work, you know, start doing all this delivery, Uber Eats, DoorDash and every other this thing, so, you know, start driving. And so even immediately you get your class 5, your the chances of you getting a well-paying job will be high, because if you have a class 5, so many companies will want to hire you because of that class 5. So because of your class 5, so many companies will want to hire you, you know, just to, because they know that you are different from people that doesn't have, and your chances are high, so because you have this class 5 license. So now this will be the end of the video, so take care.